Something I can proudly say hasn't happened in real life. Clear left and right, round we go. And we'll just creep along here. And we can go across here at an angle to line up. Close throttles and roll up to the hold bar. So we're currently lining up at kilo 7. I'll just check that out on the map. Still 2-7 left. So we've got the right runway. Okay. Ground roll stopped. Parking brake on. Shall leave the lights as they are just for the moment whilst I look at the chart. We're currently at kilo 7. So we are here, so we're just missing it by one, to be honest. I prefer that. Okay, so we should be up by kilo 3 or so, I should think. Excellent, so lining up kilo 7 for 2-7 left. Okay, we'll accept our lineup clearance. Lights, standing lights are on. Taxis are off. Strobe is now on. Brakes are off, and forward we go. No traffic on the TCAS. Visual clear right, visual clear left. Actually, I can see an aircraft trying to roll down the runway there. I'm just going to stop here, because I don't want that to hit us. Looks like the simulator's going up on the 09s. I'll let this aircraft go. It's now rolling. Lucky I looked. And up he goes. We'll only gain a bit of altitude. Okay, and here we go. He's coming off on our TCAS. Away he goes. Okay, so lining up, if I have a look at the radial now, that considering where we are, that's pretty much it on runway heading, so I'm just going to readjust my runway heading. I would say 266, and I'll make some manual adjustments in the climb. So our lights are good, all the buttons look good, seatbelts are on, auto brakes are on, RTO. Don't need to arm the spoilers, that's automatic. Some people make the mistake of doing this, and then they wonder why the alarm goes off when they apply power. So don't do that. And it looks like we're ready to go. So we've got 2600, we'll be on runway heading. I'll put the bank limiter actually on the 15. We don't want to do any steep banks when we're low and slow. And I'll just centralise these windows so I'm not sodding around later. Make that a tiny bit smaller. Okay, and of course I'll put this in the middle as always. Excuse the fiddling, it needs to be done. Excellent. So we're going out to NERMO, that's going to be intercepted a bit later. VNAV 250 to 10,000, assuming I press VNAV, which I won't, and 314 up to 0.782. Okay, 3, 2, 1, go. Power up to about 60 or so. To make sure the engines are stable, the engines are looking stable, and over to take off power. Take off power set. that alignment, we pretty much maintain where we're heading to 66. It's pretty good. Go. Two, 3 meters a second. And we're looking to maintain at 175. Positive climb gear up. And I'm pitching to hold about 175 and trimming. So it's giving us 2,800. I should now hand over to autopilot. 2,900 or so. And where are we heading at 266? We want to get to the first circle and we'll start a gentle right turn to intercept 329. And then if I pop this onto the VOR page, you can see that we're pretty much following that very centralised. And that's at 250. On the VORs. And centralise, you can see that we get our VORs tuning in. That's 5, and remember it's 1.5, that ring, just now. We'll start our right turn now to heading 329. Climb power. Small reduction there. I was used to rate it for climb. Might increase the rate of turn a little bit more. We should intercept that radial pretty nicely. Given a clearance now up to 9,000. And gear handle off. Going to collapse one. Press speed. And we're now going to be following that 329 radial, which is pretty spot on there. 10.1 will start the right turn out to it's called. Now it's just occurred to me that I forgot to put, which I thought would happen, my transition altitude, which was 4,000. So if I put that in now, because we have passed 4,000, I'll have to press to get the standard pressure there, 2992. That normally happens at 18,000 because that's the default. Flaps up. So I just put it in there a bit late, but I should have put that down on the ground and we would have got the warning telling us to change at 4,000, like it does at default 18,000. And I happen to know that the Brussels area, the Belgium transition altitude is 4,500. I'll set that in the cruise. I'll do my best to remember that. Power coming back now for 250, and we'll continue to climb through up to our cruise altitude 17,000. Just about to intercept the LNAV path, so LNAV on. Nav page, I should put in BT flight and that. So it's picking up another one, looking for that. I'll turn off VOR2. So we're turning exactly on that 10.1 ring. And that's a perfect departure. And we're flying all the way out now to Nürnberg. I'll turn off the other stations and the other airports for the time being. So what we have here is the radial from the Charles de Gaulle VOR and a bearing from the BT VOR, which we followed out to 10.1. We're now on direct path to them. Just past 10,000, and that's off. And we'll now press VNAV. VNAV's going to pitch down and take us up to 314. Pretty heavy. I don't want to be climbing up on full power, so I would use it to climb at 1 to reduce our rate of climb a little bit. Save wear and tear on the engines, reduce fuel flow a little bit, and a little bit noise, a little less noise from passengers as well. Everything helps, as Tesco said. So that's 1200. In reality, 1275 is the default acceleration pitch for the 777. It's going to level less than 314. Now that value is going to reduce as we get a bit lighter, so that might update itself to 313, which will be reflected here, and then reflected here. Now we're going to start to pitch up to wave goodbye to Paris. And seeing that aircraft just made me think to put the TCAS on TARA now. And the 14,000 I'll turn off for the seatbelts. So we're now giving an excellent climb rate of 4,000 feet per minute. It's pretty steep. I'll just go ahead and put that to climb 2 now to reduce the climb rate a bit, considering we're quite close to 17,000. It's reduced itself now to 2,500 feet per minute, which is a bit more acceptable than 2,000 to go. 73,000 to go, sorry. Okay, looking good. 2,000 just about passed, so we'll see if that's more time. Clean up this page a bit now. Delete the fixes, which will remove the wings. And this green line is the radial from the nav, nav radio. So I will delete that. So we've just cleaned up our navigation display. So I can now put on the airports and stations. 900 to go, and pitch down now. And 25 to go to them. I think that we're levelling out too soon, but like I said, it's only 150 nautical miles, and a lot of that's already been flown already. Then the forecast page, transition level, I'm now going to set that to 4,500. Sorry, 4.5, you have to write it as flight level. That's going to remove that warning. So that's for the descent, that's how you can set your transition altitude in flight. Total distance now, distance to go 20, distance to go to the airport 120. Good, so now we're level. Cleaned up a little bit. I'm now going to put in the arrival information, so I'll pop over to the arrival chart. And you remember seeing this chart here, this is the arrival. So our initial approach fix is Kirky, and I want to fly to Kirky, and I'll set the VOR up as bub, and I'm going to put a fix for the intermediate fix, which is 13.9. So I'm going to do a fix for the 13.9. I won't use a radial on there. I'll use a radial on the radio nav page, and that radial will be 261. That's the path. And I'm actually going to put two wings on this, because you can see the one is going to be for the intermediate fix, and one is going to be for the final turn at 4.4. We also have some altitude information down here, which I'll look at in the descent. So the first thing I'm going to do is put in Kirky. I'll put 4,000 on the legs page to help the VNAV, and I'm going to put 13.9 and 4.4 as a fix ring from bub. A lot to remember. And I'll try to remember all that now. From in Kirky first. Excellent. So we're going to fly directly to Kirky first of all. So the unknown is now routed out to Kirky. That's good. And here's the airport. So you can see that represents the map a little bit already. And I want to be there at 4,000. And let's reset the speed to 240, because I'm below 10,000. So I'll execute that.